Hi guys, so today this is Claire here and I'm going to be starting a new series of videos that are probably going to pop up frequently, and it's basically, it doesn't really have a name or anything, but since most of the things that I craft for my dolls are my Froggy stuff tutorials, I'm going to be kind of showing you guys how I'm doing it and maybe the variations that I'm adding or like tips and stuff. And yeah, so I hope you guys enjoy and let's get started. So basically off camera, I've done some things, obviously. So the first thing I did was I made a pattern and I can't seem to find the 12-inch one, but pretty much I just took some paperboard. This is for my box of crackers. And I sort of drew it with the doll as a guide. So this is the 18-inch one. And that'll be the front and the back of the house. And then I also drew one for the side. And then since I don't have any brown cardstock, I trace canned craft foam. And I cut out the pieces for the 12-inch one, but I haven't done that for the 18-inch one yet. So I'm gonna do that now. And I just traced them all together so I could save space, but then I'm gonna cut them apart. So I'll be right back. Okay, sorry that the first minute and 30 seconds or so was in portrait mode. I wasn't thinking. I haven't filmed in a while. So as you can see, I have cut out the basic four do that off camera because I cannot cut one hand. All right, now the background noise that you hear is the dishwasher and not my sister. So I have all the pieces cut out now, and these are the pieces for the 18-inch dollhouse, and these are the pieces for the 12-inch dollhouse. So now I'm going to start to hot glue these together, and I'm just going to hot glue. So I've got a house shape. Yeah. All right, as you can see, the hot glue did leave a little residue, sort of. But when I'm all done, I'm going to use scissors to cut that off, and I might pull some off too. See, the bag that I'm gluing on has already kind of pulled a lot off. It kind of looks like plastic wrap. So now I have both of my houses all glued together and trimmed and everything. So this is the 12-inch house. This is actually showing the 11-inch house. This is Briar Beauty. She's an Ever After High doll. And as you can see, I did make this house much wider than the American Girl house. Yeah. And I didn't bother to cut off all of the glue on the houses. As you can see, there's still some right here and some right here. Because I'm going to be... I'm so sorry. This video is really going tilty on you guys. I will try to fix that in the rest of this video and in later videos. I am obviously not as good of a filmer as my sister. So now I'm going to be making rooms for these houses, and I'm going to be using white craft foam, but you can really use any craft foam that you want. I'm just using white because I want it to be white icing on the roofs. So you can make it brown if you want, pink for hair. It could be any color you want, really. So I'm just going to take my little handy dandy pencil, and I'm going to mark the width that I want this roof to be. So little bit of overhang. So I'm just gonna mark it right about here. And then you can mark it down here and mark it out. Yeah. All right. As you can see, I have cut out the roof for the 18-inch house and for the 10 to 12-inch house as well. So now I'm going to be going over and gluing them. So I'm just going to be putting hot glue on these two sides and then placing them on, because you don't really need to put hot glue right here on these sides. Once you've got the roofs all glued on, it should look something like this. A gingerbread house that just looks like this. Not me. So now I'm going to move on to decorating. First, I'm going to make some shingles for my house. So as you can see here, I've cut a strip of white craft foam and I've cut some little slits in it, if you can see that. For doing this is to put, I guess it's sort of like the slits in all of the strip and then to cut it into little pieces before you round it off. That's what I like to do because it helps to work with just like a little small piece. Or you can do what I'm doing if you don't want to do the shingles, because the shingles can be a little bit hard. What I'm doing is I'm just going to be using a shrink in the middle to hide that crack. So I'm going to cut a strip of white craft foam, similar to the strip that I cut for the shingles. Next, what you do is you cut it down to the correct size, and then, once these are all twisted and glued. So this is what it should look like when you're done, if not a little neater. Though, if you keep finding that you're burning yourself when you're trying to put this down, because you're trying to keep it twisted and you're trying to glue it down both at the same time, then you can just leave the strip flat and glue it down, as that works just as well for hiding any cracks. And then if you would like, you can also use the trim to go down the sides as like columns or pillars or just to hide glue, you know. So I'm gonna do that. Okay, let's see. There. So now that I have my trim, going to be gluing on doors. And as you can see, I have not twisted for the trim. That was because I tried, but then I hurt myself. So I just left it straight like I did for this roof. And now I'm going to be using this scrap of paper. So I'm just going to be using my glue stick to glue it right there. Okay, so now I have my gingerbread houses all decorated, and now I'm going to explain to you what I did. So I have these paint pens that I used for decorating. I used them to draw on shingles, draw on windows, doorknobs, window panes. They're really beautiful. And I had a nice scarf that I had. I had a number of colors that I had. And these candy canes right here are just two colors that I twisted together, like I mentioned in the video. And then I shaped them into a candy cane. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video and would like to see more of them, then please give it a big thumbs up and comment down. And please check out more of my videos and subscribe if you want to. Well, who wouldn't want to? So, I hope you have a great day or night or whatever time you are watching this video at, and bye.